टुडेज डिस्कशन इज अबाउट टंग, राइट? टुडेज डिस्कशन इज अबाउट टंग. सो वी आई फर्स्ट ब्रीफ यू व्हाट पॉइंट्स वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन टंग एंड देन वी विल स्टार्ट विद द डिस्कशन. ओके. एनाटोमी ऑफ टंग. एनाटोमी ऑफ टंग. सो इफ यू सी, वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू सी द डिटेल्स ऑफ द डेवलपमेंट बिकॉज वी ऑलरेडी सॉ इन द वीडियो व्हेन वी डिस्कस अबाउट द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर्स फ्रॉम द फारेंजियल आर्चेस, पाउचेस, राइट? From the pharyngeal clefts, etc. So it develops from pharyngeal arches, right? But not the muscles, right? Muscles of the tongue don't develop from the pharyngeal arches. The mucosa and the lining and all these develops, but the muscles develop from the, can anyone tell me? It develops from the mesoderm. Which kind of mesoderm? Can anyone tell me? Primary or secondary? Okay, this is a homework for you. So remember that tongue muscles develop from the mesoderm. Okay. Now we're not going to discuss about the development because we already discussed it. Histology, I'll not go in details. That can be covered somewhere else. The circumvallate papillae and other papillae also. So those circumvallate papillae and all these we can be discussed in different topic. Okay, that is not my concern. We are just talking about the general, you can say strictly about the anatomy. Okay, so now today what we are going to discuss is, we're going to discuss the formation of tongue. Formation in the sense, what constitutes the tongue? What constitutes the tongue, that is the muscles of the tongue. Then we are going to see about, now muscles are two, extrinsic and intrinsic. Okay, extrinsic and intrinsic. So we will see about them in extensive detail, and then we will be discussing about the, of course, the blood supply, which includes the arterial as well as the venous drainage, arterial supply and the venous drainage, the nerve supply. We have already seen in extensive detail, but still we will revise it, and we can see the lymphatic drainage and of course the applied anatomy. So this is what we are going to cover in today's discussion. So let us go to it one by one. Now first we will go to the constituents of the tongue, that is the muscles of the tongue. Now I will enumerate and I will tell about them one by one, and then we will go to the details for the different diagrams. Okay, so now if you see I will tell you about the muscles. Okay, now we will see the extrinsic muscles here and intrinsic muscles. Okay, intrinsic muscles and extrinsic muscles. Now if you see, there are four intrinsic, four extrinsic. Okay, four intrinsic and four extrinsic. So they're very easy to be remembered because, you know, anatomy is all about names. Now first I will tell you intrinsic, very easy. Superior longitudinal. Now from the name only you can understand. Say if this is the tongue, okay, tumne kya kiya, you removed the, see, this person is facing, actually a person is facing to you. I'll give you the orientation of the diagram. Person is facing to you. What did you do? You stood on a stool, okay, and you chopped off his head like this. From where? Upar ka jo jaw hai uska, upper, you know, you upper half of the buccal cavity. From there, you took a transverse section and you put it off, and now you are viewing it from this above. So you, for you, the tongue is like this. So this becomes your anterior. This is your posterior. You are viewing a superior, you know, view. Now this is the left of the person and this is the right of the person. Now when you are viewing like this, okay, when you are viewing like this, superior longitudinal means like this. Intrinsic muscles are the muscles which are within the substance of the tongue. When you go in the mirror, put see your mouth in the tongue and you do seeing your tongue. You, what tongue as a whole structure, what you see is formed from these four intrinsic muscles. Okay. Okay. Superior longitudinal muscles, inferior longitudinal muscles, and you have the transverse muscles, okay, and vertical muscles. Okay. Now from this you can understand. ट्रांसफर, ये सुपीरियर लॉन्जिट्यूडनल मतलब अगर ऐसा, अगर टंग का थिकनेस है तो ये सुपीरियर ऊपर जो है लॉन्जिट्यूडनल, नीचे जो लॉन्जिट्यूडनल दैट इज इन्फीरियर लॉन्जिट्यूडनल, एंड ट्रांसवर्स मतलब ऐसा रहेगा टंग में, और वर्टिकल, वर्टिकल मतलब ऐसा खड़ा रहेगा. सो दीज आर द थ्री डायमेंशन इन विच वी आर सींग द टंग, इंट्रेंसिक टंग मसल. दे आर फॉर्मिंग द टंग एज अ होल, वॉट यू कैन सी फ्रॉम आउटसाइड. इफ यू गो इन द मिरर एंड सी दिस कंप्लीट स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द टंग, वॉट यू सी इन द मिरर इज नथिंग बट ऑल द गेम ऑफ दीज फोर इंट्रेंसिक मसल्स. Understood? Now if you see, I will erase this bit. If you see the extrinsic muscles, so easy to remember, you know, superior longitudinal, inferior longitudinal, and transverse and vertical. Very simple to remember. Now if you see the extrinsic muscle. Extrinsic muscles means the muscles which are having connection to the tongue from outside. Okay, they're very interesting. And we discussed a couple of muscles yesterday when we were talking about styloid apparatus. So I'll enumerate them from the name itself, you can understand. I mean, it's not extensively important for you remember the point from which it is getting originated and point where it is getting inserted as a first year student. But of course, if you are doing surgery, I mean, if you are studying surgery or if you are studying third year subject, clinical subject, at that time you need to know the extensive details. But right now it is okay, from the name you can just orient yourself ki which muscle is present where. And when I will show you the diagrams from the atlas, you will be very much clear with the concepts from where the muscle is extending to which place it is inserting. Okay, origin, insertion, everything. So, and if you, of course, now in the lockdown, you're not able to do the dissection, otherwise you would have understood far better. No issues, we will do it in the atlas and photographs here. So the four muscles are, extrinsic muscles are, palatoglossus, palatoglossus. So from the palate, hard palate to the glossa. Whether it is hard palate or soft palate, you are going to tell me. It is the soft palate, okay? Palatoglossus. I will show you everything, whatever I am writing, I will show it to you in the diagram. And try to be diagrammatic in the exam so that examiner will come to know this guy knows. Okay? Then palatoglossus. Glossa is tongue, as you all know. So, if you see, now I will enumerate, then I will tell what I want to tell you. Hyoglossus means from hyoid bone to the glossa, that is the tongue. Then the third muscle is styloglossus, which we discussed yesterday. From the styloid process to the glossa. And genioglossus, that is from the genial tubercle. This also we discussed yesterday. And I told you sometime back also when we were talking about mandible. If you see, there is one thing in common, that all these spelling, these are spellings, they are ending with glossus. Means what? I will tell you. This name of the, I mean the sequence of the spelling of the terms is giving you the idea of origin and insertion of the muscle. It means what? These muscles are getting originated from the first half of the spelling of these names. And they are getting inserted into the second half. Means what? All these extrinsic muscles are getting inserted into the glossa. Are you understanding? And they are getting originated from the different parts which we have enumerated. Origin is from outside. Outside the tongue. And so they are called as extrinsic muscles. Understood? So they are called as extrinsic muscles. Now, intrinsic muscles, they originate inside the tongue, what you see as a muscular structure, and they get inserted inside the tongue itself. So they are called as intrinsic muscles. You understood about the eight different types of muscles which the tongue is constituted of. Okay? Which the tongue is constituted of. Now we will go into detail of each and every muscle. See, this is the diagram for intrinsic muscles. Okay. Intrinsic muscles. Now I will give you the orientation of the diagram. Already it is written that this is a coronal section. Coronal section means what? I will tell you. See, how you need to get oriented. Person is standing in front of you. He is looking towards you. You take a coronal section, either coronal suture, you take a section along it, and now you are seeing the tongue. So what happens if the tongue is like this? You took a coronal section, now you are viewing it like this. Are you understanding? So this is the cut section. Understood? Simple it is. This is the thickness of the, simply this is the thickness of the tongue. Understand like this. Okay? This is the thickness of the tongue. Understood? Now I will erase all this. If you see, so you might have got oriented, right? This is the superior. This is the inferior. This is the right because it is your left. And on the other side, this is the left. This is the tongue. You are viewing from anterior. You are viewing from anterior. This is the anterior view of the सामने वाला खड़ा है तुमने उसको coronal suture के along cut किया तुम उसके सामने से देख रहे हो तो this is the anterior view and along the coronal section. Now we saw there are four muscles, right? Wait, I will erase. Just one second. I'm sorry. This is right. This is left. This is superior. This is inferior. And this is the anterior view, right? Now, if you see, there are four muscles as we already discussed, right? Superior longitudinal muscle, inferior longitudinal muscle, then ये दो भाई भाई हो गए उसके बाद ट्रांसवर्स मसल एंड वर्टिकल मसल. नाउ आई विल टेल यू फ्रॉम द नेम इटसेल्फ यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज देयर एक्शन. इट इज सो सिंपल. ओके एंड यू कैन गेट ओरिएंटेड दैट जस्ट वन सेकंड. यू कैन सिंपली गेट ओरिएंटेड सो इफ यू सी इज द डायग्राम विजिबल. ओके सो इफ यू सी नाउ आई टेल यू द फंक्शन ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी मसल. Now, longitudinal means what? See, now I am changing the direction of the tongue. Okay. Like this if your tongue is. Okay. So, you are viewing from this side. So, this is the thickness of the tongue. Okay. Now, here you have this superior longitudinal muscle. So, when you cut it, you will see like two, just like two rods. Which are cut along the cross section. So, longitudinal muscle kaisa hai? From the posterior part to the anterior part. Aisa. Right. So, even if suppose the origin is here. And insertion is here. Now, if this muscle contracts, what will happen? Muscle always contracts from where? From the insertion side. I told you the other side, other day. So, if it contracts, it is going to go in this direction, right? So, what is the role of superior longitudinal muscle? Can you tell me? It will shorten the tongue. And it will make what? It will make it dorsum concave. Dorsum means what? Your posterior aspect. Ventral means what? Your anterior aspect. So dorsum, your head is the dorsum aspect, right? If you are lying ulta, means what? Suppose this is the floor and you are lying like this, okay? And you are like this. This is called as lie down position, okay? Lie down position. So if you are viewing like this, so this is your dorsum. This is your ventral part, okay? Ventral part. Now, this ventral part, if you see, this is your dorsum. So your tongue will be like this. If you protrude it out, your tongue will be like this. So this becomes the dorsum of your tongue. Just one second. This is the dorsum of your tongue and this is the ventral part of your tongue. Understood? I will write it in yellow. See, this is the dorsum of your tongue. Okay? And this is the ventral part of your tongue. Right? So, if you see this dorsum, it will make it dorsoconcave. Means what? If this contracts like this, what will happen? What will happen? This gets contracted in this way. This contracted this way. And then it will make it dorsoconcave. Okay, dorsoconcave. Understood? So the action of the superior longitudinal muscle is shortening the tongue and making it dorsoconcave. I hope you are understanding. Superiorly, if it makes contracted, see, this is the thickness. As I already told you, this is the thickness of the tongue. So upar wale contract ho gaye, to ye kya ho jayega? Is tarike se, it will become dorsum concave. Okay? Now next muscle. So the next muscle, the intrinsic muscle, is the inferior longitudinal muscle. Okay. Now inferior means what? It is on the inferior aspect, but it is in the same direction. That is the longitudinal direction. Now I told you this is the thickness. Superior upar ho gaya, inferior niche. Longitudinal, same. Now what will happen? Again, if this is going to contract, what is going to happen? See, I'll show you in green color. If this is contracting, again the tongue will shorten. Okay, again the tongue will shorten. Yeah? Okay. Is it audible now? I hope it is audible now. Okay. So, this tongue will shorten because it is in the same direction on contraction of the inferior longitudinal muscle. And now it will become this way. Are you understanding? Before it was like this. Now it will become like this because the inferior muscles are getting contracted. I hope you understand. If all these muscles contract, it will become dorsoconvex. And when you can say, see, ye upar wala dorsum hai. So this is dorsum convex. Or you can say it will become ventral concave. Any name you can give. The previous one was dorsum. See, this way, it was the dorsoconcave one. Now it becomes dorsoconvex. Because we are dorsum ke aspect mein uska side bol rahe. So it becomes the dorsoconvex. So superior longitudinal muscle will shorten the tongue and make it dorsoconcave. Inferior longitudinal muscle will again contract the muscle, contract the tongue, shorten the tongue, and dorsoconvex, or you can say ventroconcave. Understood? This is about superior longitudinal muscle. Now transverse. Sochne wali baat hai, agar ye muscle contract ho gai, to iska length kya ho jayega? Chota ho jayega. To ye tongue ko kya karegi? Tongue ko narrow karegi? See, if this contraction happens, it will happen in this direction. Wait, I will rectify myself. Just one second. See this. Yeah. So contraction will happen in this direction. So tongue will become narrow, tongue will become elongated. Are you understanding? All these muscles shortened. So ye jo aisa badi sari tongue thi, it will become narrow and elongated. This is the role of transverse muscle. Talking about the vertical muscles. See this vertical muscles, I put it in blue. Vertical muscle, if you see, simple again, transverse ka matlab opposite ho jayega thoda sa. If you see, vertical is like this. They are in the standing position. Standing position means when you put a finger on your lip, the direction of the finger that is the direction of the vertical muscle of the tongue. Are you understanding? Direction of the finger, jo standing finger hai, finger on your lip, that is the direction of the vertical muscle. I already told you this is a coronal section, already written here. Coronal section. So coronal section means what? You understood from the along the coronal suture. So you are just going to see the thickness of the tongue. So along the thickness, it is like this. This is the direction of the vertical muscle in your tongue. Now what it will do if it contracts? See, if it contracts like this, just one second. See, this is the direction, as I told you, like this. Okay, this is the direction. Finger on your lip direction. I hope you are able to imagine. Now, if it contracts like this, what will happen? Tongue will become flattened. Yes or no? Jo thickness hai, it will become flattened. And it will become broadened. Are you understanding? Suppose, if there is a plate. Wo plate ka jo face hai, upar aur niche se. उसको तुमने हाथोड़ से मारा, प्रेशर अप्लाई किया, व्हाट विल हैपन? वो चपटा हो जाएगा, बड़ा हो जाएगा. सेम हियर, वी आर नॉट अप्लाइंग एनी फोर्स, इट इज द एक्शन ऑफ द मसल्स. अरेंजमेंट ऑफ फाइबर्स ऑफ द मसल्स इज सच दैट व्हेन दे कॉन्ट्रैक्ट यू विल गेट अ ब्रॉडेंड एंड फ्लैटेंड टंग. दिस इज द एक्शन ऑफ द वर्टिकल मसल्स. सो आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड द डायरेक्शंस ऑफ द four intrinsic muscles. I'll just very briefly, tabulate them for you. So, superior longitudinal muscle, what it is doing? It is shortening and, shortening and what it is doing? What else? Shortening and dorsoconcave. Okay. And inferior longitudinal is also shortening but dorsoconvex. And vertical muscles is, it is broadening, broad and flat, flat tongue. Okay. And transverse muscle, what it is doing? It is narrowing and elongating it, making it long. Have you understood? Simple. So, if a patient of tongue injury comes to you, jaise bachon ka jeeb kat jata hai na, chote rehte tab, when they are chewing food. So, such kind of patients will come to you. So, you need to know the anatomy. Are jis jeeb se itna bird karte hai, especially people like me who are so much extrovert, keep on speaking and for hours together. So, you know, at least we should know what is our tongue. Does your tongue pain anytime? कभी जीभ दुखती है क्या बात कर करके कि भाई आज तो मेरा बात करके जीभ दुख रहा है. एनी मसल यू टेक इन योर बॉडी इट विल हैव पेन. यस, एनी मसल यू कैन टेक, नेक मसल्स, थाई मसल्स, चेस्ट मसल्स, इफ यू डू वर्कआउट देर इज पेन. बट टंग विच कीप्स ऑन स्पीकिंग कंटिन्यूअसली इट नेवर पेन्स. हैव यू एवर इमेजिन व्हाट इज द मिरेकल बिहाइंड दिस? ओके, वी आर गोइंग अवे फ्रॉम द टॉपिक. नाउ वी विल कम टू द डिस्कशन ऑफ एक्सट्रिंसिक मसल्स. नाउ वी आर टू द डिस्कशन ऑफ एक्सट्रिंसिक मसल्स. नाउ इफ यू रिकॉल द फोर एक्सट्रिंसिक मसल्स, if you see the four extrinsic muscles, palatoglossus, hyoglossus, styloglossus and genioglossus. Ab maine kyun likh diya? Taki humko easy ho jaye. Theek hai, abhi sabse bada, sabse bulky agar koi muscle hai to genioglossus hai. Tum yahan bhaiyo behno naam se dekh sakte ho. Ye dekho genioglossus muscle. Can you see such a big muscle? See this big muscle. Ye hyoglossus ki wajah se thoda chup gaya hai, but I hope you are able to make it. Yes, you are able to make it. Now, if you see genioglossus muscle, it is extending from where? From genial tubercle. Now, I already shared the video of mandible on the group, YouTube video from our batchmate, and he has very beautifully explained the parts of mandible, and in that he has explained, see, there are two genial tubercles here. I will show you, see. Actually, इधर दो जीनियल ट्यूबरकल होता है, एक सुपीरियर होता है, एक इंफीरियर, या अपर जीनियल ट्यूबरकल और लोअर जीनियल ट्यूबरकल. तो ये अपर जीनियल ट्यूबरकल ऑफ मैंडिबल में से ओरिजिन होने वाला जीनियोग्लॉसस मसल. इट गोज एंड इंसर्ट्स इन द ग्लॉसा. बिकॉज ऑफ दीज मसल्स वी आर नॉट एबल टू सी द इंसर्शन ऑफ द जीनियोग्लॉसस मसल. आई एम सॉरी, आई डिड नॉट गिव यू द ओरिएंटेशन ऑफ द डायग्राम, बट ऑलरेडी यू हैव सीन दिस डायग्राम यस्टरडे. सी, दिस इज द लिप, राइट? दिस इज द लिप, दिस इज द चिन. ओके, दिस इज द मैस्टॉइड प्रोसेस. तो ये हो गया तुम्हारा पोस्टीरियर, ये हो गया तुम्हारा एंटीरियर, और ये तुमने क्या लिया? सजाइटल सेक्शन लिया. बंदे को खड़ा किया है, बंदा इस तरफ देख रहा है, तुमने उसको सजाइटल सूचर के अलॉन्ग कट कर दिया, और फिर तुम उसका लेफ्ट साइड का पार्ट निकाल दिया. ये ऑलरेडी इट इज रिटन लैटरल व्यू, लेफ्ट साइड ऑफ द मैंडिबल इज रिमूव. सो यू आर व्यूइंग इन दिस डायरेक्शन. आर यू एबल टू मेक इट? यस. नाउ इफ यू सी, आई विल गिव यू द ओरिएंटेशन ऑफ वन बाय वन ऑल द मसल. सो जीनियोग्लॉसस इज अ वेरी बल्की मसल, एंड वी हैव सीन द ओरिजिन इंसर्शन. ग्लॉसा इट मींस टंग, एंड ऑल दीज मसल्स आर गोइंग एंड गेटिंग इंसर्टेड इनटू द टंग, बट देयर ओरिजिन इज आउटसाइड द टंग, सो दे आर कॉल्ड एज एक्सट्रिंसिक मसल्स. नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट मसल, आई एम गोइंग टू यूज रेड कलर. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट styloglossus muscle. Yesterday we discussed about the styloid process. Can you see the styloid process, which is just medial to the opening of your ear? External auditory meatus ke opening ke just medially, mastoid process ke just aage aur medially, anteromedially to the mastoid process and medially to the external auditory meatus opening, you have a process called as styloid process. It gives attachment to three muscles and two ligaments. We already discussed yesterday in the detail when we talked about styloid apparatus. Now we are concerned about styloglossus muscle. स्टाइलॉइड प्रोसेस से आने वाला ग्लॉसा, जो ग्लॉसा में माने टंग में जा रहा है. तो आपको इधर लेबलिंग दिखा दो, स्टाइलोग्लॉसस मसल. कैन यू सी इट? स्टाइलोग्लॉसस मसल. सी, इफ यू आर गोइंग अलॉन्ग द एरो, यू विल अंडरस्टैंड दिस इज द मसल. तो ये टंग में जा रहा है, दिख रहा है आपको? फाइबर दे आर गोइंग इन टू द टंग. सो दिस इज द, आई विल इरेज दिस सो दैट यू कैन सी द एक्चुअल डायग्राम. स्टाइलोग्लॉसस दिख रहा है, स्टाइलोग्लॉसस मसल. सो ओरिजिनेटिंग फ्रॉम द स्टाइलॉइड प्रोसेस एंड ऑन द मीडियल एस्पेक्ट ऑफ द स्टाइलॉइड प्रोसेस. इफ यू आंसर the five attachments of the styloid apparatus, examiner will tell you, ask you the next question, which part or which aspect of the styloid process does the styloglossus gets originated? So it's the medial aspect. It is the medial aspect. Okay, ye bahar ka jo muscle hai, that is the styloid, that is on the lateral aspect. Yesterday we discussed it. So styloglossus muscle. Okay, now we will talk about hyoglossus. So that is the hyoid bone. Simple, from the name you can see, here is the hyoid bone, this is the hyoid bone. I will erase it so that you can see the actual bone. And hyoid bone se kaha ja raha hai? Glossa, that is the tongue. So I will highlight the muscle, hyoglossus. If you trace the arrow, this is the hyoid bone muscle. Can you see this origin from here? I will erase this. From the origin of this hyoid bone to where it is going, to the glossa, that is the tongue. Samajh mein? Tongue. उसके बाद हायर्ड बोन से टंग में जाता है. तो इफ यू सी, इफ यू वांट टू नो द एक्जैक्ट ओरिजिन ऑफ द हायोक्लासिस मसल्स ऑन द हायर्ड बोन, यू कैन गो एंड स्टडी अबाउट द डिटेल ऑफ द हायर्ड बोन, लेसर कॉर्नुआ, ग्रेटर कॉर्नुआ एंड बॉडी एंड ऑल दैट. ओके, देन पैलेटोग्लॉसिस. पैलेटोग्लॉसिस मतलब पैलेट. पैलेट मुझे टाइम, आई हैव ऑलरेडी आस्क्ड यू टू एक्सपेरिमेंट दिस व्हेन आई वाज टॉकिंग टू यू अबाउट द स्कल बोन्स. सो यू पुट योर फिंगर इनसाइड योर माउथ अबाउ सुपीरियर साइड, यू विल सी सम हार्ड स्ट्रक्चर, दैट इज द हार्ड पैलेट, दैट इज दिस, इट इज फॉर्म्ड बाय द मैक्सिलरी बोन, राइट पैलेट, एंड बिहाइंड यू हैव द पैलेटाइन बोन ऑल्सो. एंड ये हार्ड पैलेट है, इसके ऊपर म्यूकोसा का लेयरिंग है, इसीलिए तुमको कुछ हार्ड इतना लगता नहीं. और ये पीछे का जो पार्ट, दिस इज द सॉफ्ट पैलेट, मसल्स ऑफ द सॉफ्ट पैलेट, एंड इट्स ऑल्सो एसएक्यू क्वेश्चन, वाइवा क्वेश्चन, इट्स अ डिफरेंट टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन, वी विल हैव अ सेपरेट वेबिनार ऑन दिट. बट सॉफ्ट पैलेट, ओके, मसल्स ऑफ द सॉफ्ट पैलेट, फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द सॉफ्ट पैलेट एंड ऑल दिस, ओके, दिस इज देयर. सो सॉफ्ट पैलेट इज देयर विच गिव्स अटैचमेंट टू दिस पैलेटोग्लॉसिस मसल, which gives attachment to this palatoglossus muscle. If you see, see, this is the palatoglossus muscle. And if you trace it, it's here. Okay, so ye palate mein se aa raha hai, glossa mein ja raha hai. Understood? Palatoglossus muscle. So ye, once you get oriented with this diagram, never ever in your life you can forget it. Understood? So have you understood? Have you understood? I hope it is very clear. Now I will tell you the actions of one. It is very simple. You can also understand. Now if you see, genioglossus. Iska origin kidhar hai? Idhar hai. Insertion kidhar hai? Idhar hai. So when it will contract, the direction of contraction will be like this, right? So when it is getting contracted, so ye jeev ko bahar khinch raha hai. So genioglossus will protrude the tongue. Understood? It will protrude the tongue. Very simple. Genioglossus. Next muscle I will mark with blue the action of it. Hyoglossus. Hyoglossus kidhar hai? Ye idhar hai. Hyoglossus kidhar hai? Idhar hai. Hyoid bone piche tongue idhar hai. Direction of the muscle I have already shown. So when it will, now it is getting inserted inside the tongue. So when it will contract in this direction, insertion ke idhar se hamesha muscle ka movement hota hai. I have already told you. So when this muscle contracts, so it will contract in this direction. What will happen? It is depressing the tongue. Understood? It is depressing the tongue. Very simple. Now next muscle, I will use the black color. Okay. So if you see, it is the styloglossus in my list. So if you see the styloglossus muscle kidhar hai? Ye aage se aisa piche aa raha hai. This is the direction of the fibers, right? So when it will contract, I will use again green color. When it will contract like this, means what? It is contracting in this direction. Are you understanding? It is contracting in this direction. So what will happen? It will retract the tongue. So genioglossus or styloglossus, ye dono kya ho gaye? Pratidvandvi, opposite. Genioglossus is protruding the tongue and styloglossus is retracting the tongue. Understood? Now bacha palatoglossus, I will use yellow color. I have already shown the direction of this palatoglossus muscle. See this way. Now if you see, this is the direction. Okay, I will erase that one. So just one second. I'll show it. Palatoglossus. Oh, sab gadbad ho gaya. Okay, leave it. This is the palatoglossus muscle. Okay, so palatoglossus muscle ka direction ye, from palate, soft palate to the glossa. So jab contract hoga, I am using black color. This will contract in this direction. So what it is doing? It will elevate the tongue. So hope you understand. Genioglossus and styloglossus, they are opposite action. Action is opposite. Or palatoglossus, I am using blue color. Palatoglossus is elevating the tongue and hyoglossus, I have already shown in blue, it is depressing the tongue. So in the four directions, you are able to move your tongue. Hope you understand. So we saw intrinsic movements of the tongue are carried out by intrinsic muscles and extrinsic movements of the tongue are carried out by the extrinsic muscles. Jeeb ko upar karna, niche karna, bahar nikalna, andar lena. This is by extrinsic muscles. And shape of the tongue, that is broadening the tongue, flattening the tongue, this is one action. Then narrowing the tongue and thinning the tongue, that is narrowing and elongating the tongue, this is one action. Then making it shortened and convex, this is one action. Making it shortened and concave is another action. These are carried out by intrinsic muscles. And what we can see outside, the complete movement of the tongue is by these extrinsic muscles. Hope you have understood the origin, insertion and the actions of the muscles. Okay, now we will go to the whiteboard. To understand, okay, before that I have one diagram. What we will do, this discussion is about the relations of the structures along or near or dear to the tongue. Okay, so if you can see, ye hamare jeeb hai, when we see our mouth inside the, I mean in the mirror, you do a big, wide open your mouth and do and remove your tongue outside. You protrude your tongue. Now tell me, which muscle is going to allow you to protrude your tongue? It is the genioglossus. ओके जीनियोग्लॉसिस ये दिख रहा है ना इधर जीनियोग्लॉसिस मसल ये ऐसा ऐसा कॉन्ट्रैक्ट करवाएगी तो तुम्हारी जीभ ऐसा बाहर आएगी और तुम ये जब आ करके देखते हो तो तुमको इधर का पूरा गला पीछे का दिखता है व्हाट यू सी द सुपीरियर फारेंजियल कंस्ट्रिक्टर मसल ओके यू विल अंडरस्टैंड ऑल दीज नेम्स in the when we will discuss about the pharynx. As I already told you, there are three constrictor muscles of the pharynx. Always remember, superior pharyngeal, middle pharyngeal, and inferior pharyngeal constrictor muscle of the pharynx, which form the pharynx. Okay, now if you see, if you open your mouth and do a ah, you are going to see all the structures inside your neck. Matlab, tumko gale ka tube dikhega, pharynx dikhega. And as you know, that if you recall, when we had discussed about the fascia, we had seen this diagram long back. Do you recall? Just one second, I'll show it to you in proper. So this was the diagram like this. I hope you recall this, right? This is the, if you recall this, like this, or this is not a proper shape, just one second. Like this it was, okay. So, idhar piche vertebrae tha, right? Here you had your thyroid gland, uske piche trachea, uske piche esophagus. So, ye esophagus is a continuation of nothing but this oropharynx, right? Oropharynx continues as the esophagus. So, you can understand that ye, aur tumne idhar kya dekha tha? Idhar carotid sheath hai. Aur idhar kya dekha tha? Piche, I'm sorry, this one. This was nothing but the, see, here you had, I will use green color. Here you had this. This you had the pre-tracheal fascia. This was pre-vertebral fascia. And this was carotid sheath. Now the intention of this diagram, why I have brought it here, explained. Carotid sheath ke content kya, do you recall? It is the internal jugular vein. It is the internal carotid artery. Now if you see, internal carotid artery to andar tha. External carotid artery kidhar tha? Idhar bahar tha. Right, you know, common carotid, then common carotid divides inside this carotid sheath only. And inside the carotid sheath, internal carotid artery continues, external carotid comes outside. If you recall, we have discussed in extensive detail carotid sheath. You can go and check that webinar. So, carotid sheath bahar aa gaya, external carotid artery bahar aa gaya, external carotid artery. Or internal, ye jo internal jugular vein hai, wo idhar andar tha. Okay, on the inner aspect. Okay, carotid artery. So, you recall these structures. Now, if you see here also, now forget about this diagram. You got oriented with this diagram. This was anterior, this was posterior, vagara vagara. I will clear all this. Now if you see, you have these structures here. See this, external carotid artery. I'm sorry, I will highlight it. Internal jugular vein, external carotid artery, right? And external carotid artery, when we will discuss about the arterial supply of the HNF, external carotid artery, maxillary artery, all these in detail, you will come to know about all the branches of the external carotid artery. So external carotid artery is very important here. Now it is giving one branch. Now when we will discuss about the arterial supply of the tongue, at that time I will tell you in more detail after this diagram. But before you understand, see this, there is a branch going outside. Can you see this branch? I have highlighted it, wait, I will remove it. Are you able to see this branch? Ye dekho, lingual artery dikh raha hai kya tumko idhar? Ye lingual artery likha hua hai. See, this is the branch, lingual artery. Or dorsal lingual artery and vein hai, vein ko chhod do ek baar, ye idhar upar artery ja rahi hai. And then further it is dividing into deep lingual artery and submandibular duct, ye duct nahi, sorry, ye niche idhar artery hai. Sublingual artery. See, the names are according to the position. This complete is the tongue. You can understand. Genioglossus bhi tongue ka part hai. So, ye sare muscle tongue ke hai. You just see the name. Deep lingual. Lingua means what? Linguistic. You understand what you understand by the term linguistic. Linguistic is language. Language comes from tongue, right? When you speak, it becomes a language. Whatever language you are speaking. So, lingua is related to tongue. So, deep lingual artery means what? See, this complete is the tongue ka complete thickness hai. Ye niche se muscle, extrinsic muscle, intrinsic muscle. This complete is the thickness. ये थिकनेस के सबसे नीचे कौन है? डीप लिंगुअल आर्टरी. इफ यू सी द लिबलिंग, आर यू एबल टू सी इट? सी, दिस इज कमिंग फ्रॉम द बेस, राइट हियर. दिस इज द डीप लिंगुअल आर्टरी एट द बेस ऑफ द टंग. तो जब तुम टंग को ऊपर एलिवेट करते हो तो तुम्हारे को इधर नीचे एक कनेक्शन जैसा दिखता है टिश्यू, दैट इज द फ्रेन्युलम, राइट? सो वी हैव डिस्कस इन द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ टंग, बाइफिड टंग, सांप के जैसा टंग रहता है. सो दैट इज देयर. और ट्विस्टेड टंग, टंग टू ट्विस्ट. सो दैट इज डेवलपमेंटल डिफेक्ट, एनोमली. बट हियर यू सी डीप लिंगुअल artery. You will never forget if you remember with this logic, because it is deep to the tongue, so it is deep lingual. Okay, what is sublingual? Sub matlab kya? Sub matlab niche. Lingua is tongue, so tongue ke niche. This lingual artery. Understood? Then you have the sublingual artery. Okay, here, this is the sublingual artery. Lingual is what? Tongue. So this lingual artery is dividing into deep lingual and sublingual. So lingual is tongue. This complete artery is going to supply what? The tongue. And get divided into deep lingual artery and sublingual artery. Are you understanding? Are you understanding? Are you following what I am saying? So this is about this is the relation of this artery. Okay, it's a branch of lingual artery, is a branch of external carotid artery. Are you able to make it? Yeah, external carotid artery hai, ye lingual artery hai, ye iski branch hai. So simply if I want to draw a flow chart, this is external carotid artery, aur uski branch kone? Just one second. External carotid artery hai, aur uski branch kone? Lingual artery hai, aur ye lingual artery divides into deep lingual and sublingual, and it supplies the tongue. Game over. Next is, if you see this nerve. Now, ये बाकी छोटे मोटे आर्टरी है यहाँ पे, सुपरा आयोड आर्टरी एंड दिस, वी आर नॉट कंसर्न राइट नाउ, वी आर टॉकिंग जस्ट अबाउट द टंग. ओके, नाउ इफ यू कम टू दी, सो वी डिस्कस अबाउट द आर्टरी. नाउ कमिंग टू दी वेन, इफ यू सी दिस इज द इंटरनल जुगुलर वेन, इंटरनल जुगुलर वेन। ये इंटरनल जुगुलर वेन कौन कौन से ब्रांचेस देखो, इसकी लिंगुअल वेन है, ये दिख रहा है तुमको इधर लिंगुअल वेन, फिर ये लिंगुअल वेन आई एम शोइंग पर्पसली इन रेड सो द कॉन्ट्रास्ट कलर यू कैन सी इट प्रॉपर्ली। ओके, लिंगुअल वेन ये विना कमिटेंस ऑफ हाइपोग्लॉसल नर्व। कमिटेंस मतलब क्या मालूम है, डू यू नो व्हाट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट? सपोज दिस इज अ आर्टरी, ओके, अराउंड इट, अराउंड इट हियर, ओ आई एम सॉरी आई मस्ट यूज ब्लू कलर, राइट? सो अराउंड नेक्स्ट टू इट, अराउंड मतलब अदर ऑन द आइदर साइड ऐसा वेन्स रहते। सो व्हाट हैपेंस, यू नो आर्टरी हैज पल्सेशंस, सो आर्टरी, आर्टरी का पल्सेशन ऐसा ऐसा होते रहेगा ऑन बोथ द साइड, राइट? सो दिस अलाउज द ब्लड इन द वेन टू गेट पुश्ड फॉरवर्ड व्हेन द आर्टरी, सपोज इट्स लाइक दिस, ओ आई एम सॉरी आई विल यूज रेड कलर, सपोज आर्टरी इज लाइक दिस, देन इट इज पल्सेटिंग, इट बिकम्स लाइक दिस, सो द वेन्स अराउंड इट गेट, दे गेट कॉन्ट्रेक्टेड, and you know the wall of the vein is thinner, so what happens, the blood gets pushed in the forward direction, this is the mechanism of venae comitance, venae comitance, so ye hypoglossal nerve hai, so ye nerve ke aaju baju mein kya hai, venae comitance hai, understand it, the venae comitance is there are on the either side of the hypoglossal nerve. Now why hypoglossal nerve, we have already discussed when we discussed about the structures derived from the pharyngeal arches. So hypoglossal nerve, it is the nerve which supplies all the tongue muscles, extrinsic as well as the intrinsic. तो लो भैया तुम्हारा इधर नर्व सप्लाई भी हो गया, नर्व सप्लाई क्या है, नर्व सप्लाई क्या है, वेट आई विल राइट इट इन येलो सो दैट यू विल गेट ओरिएंटेड, राइट? नर्व सप्लाई ऑफ द टंग इज व्हाट, फॉर द मसल्स ऑफ द टंग इज व्हाट, इट इज द 12th करेनियल नर्व, दैट इज द हाइपोग्लॉसल नर्व। एंड अबाउट द टेस्ट सेंसेशंस एंड द सेंसरी सेंसेशंस, स्पेशल एंड जनरल, वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन डिटेल, वी विल फाइनली एट द एंड ऑफ दिस वीडियो वी विल अगेन टैबुलेट इट। सो नाउ यू अंडरस्टूड व्हाई हाइपोग्लॉसल नर्व इज देयर, राइट? नाउ फ्रॉम वेयर इट केम, दिस it exited from which foramen of the skull, you already studied in the skull, right? So I did not go in details. Now it is coming here and then it is supplying the all the tongue muscles of the tongue, okay? It is all supplying all the tongue muscle except one, that is the palatoglossus muscle. Ye jo upar se aata hai na, this is the palatoglossus muscle, palate se aata hai, palatoglossus muscle from here, it is cut here to show you, palatoglossus is supplied by the 11th cranial nerve, that is accessory cranial nerve. Oh, sab kuch mit gaya, koi baat nahi, it is getting from the 11th cranial nerve. So they will ask you a mcq question, they will ask you a mcq question, all the muscles of the tongue are supplied by hypoglossal nerve except, then they will give you options, palatoglossus, styloglossus, genioglossus, hyoglossus and other glossal muscles, okay? Otherwise they can ask you all the muscles of the tongue are supplied by dash, so it is the 12th cranial nerve. Like this mcq questions can be raised. Now coming to the relations back, we were talking about the nerve, I mean the vein. So now you understood this hypoglossal nerve, how it has come into picture, because it supplies that organ, so it is going to come there. Now if you see this, this submandibular ganglion, lingual nerve. Now lingual nerve is a branch of, who can tell me, anyone, can you tell me, can you tell me lingual nerve is a branch of, can anyone tell me lingual nerve, lingual nerve is a branch of, now it is responsible for general sensations, I have given you the hint, who is responsible for the general sensations of the tongue in the anterior two third? Yes, it is the mandibular nerve, which is the nerve of the first arch, am I right, mandibular nerve is nerve of the first arch, first pharyngeal arch. So lingual nerve is a branch of mandibular nerve which is responsible for the general sensation, and so lingual nerve is coming into picture here, understood? So I have explained you the relation of these two. Now one more important relation you should always mention, never forget, submandibular duct of Watten, it's the Watten duct. So submandibular matlab mandible ke niche, just niche you have the submandibular gland, so submandibular gland is having what, it is having the duct, that is called the submandibular duct of Watten. So it is having relation with the genioglossus muscle like this along the tongue. Now if you see, we are discussing about the veins, do bar hum vein ki discussion se bhatak gaye. So internal jugular vein, I already told you, it is the venae comitans of around the hypoglossal nerve. So ye hypoglossal nerve idhar niche, uske aaju baju mein ye veins hai. So vein, deep lingual artery hai to uska naam along the artery, same deep lingual vein, or sublingual artery ke along sublingual vein, so jo artery ka naam wahi vein ka naam, simple. So this is the relation. It is better if you are able to draw this diagram, make it diagrammatic, make it schematic, so that it becomes easy. So I have explained to you the details of the relations. We discussed about the arteries, we discussed about the veins, we discussed about the nerves, we discussed about the ducts. Ye cheeze rehti hai, bone to tumko malum hai, idhar aage mandible hai, niche hyoid hai. Nothing else is there to discuss in the relation. Now coming to the arterial supply, nerve supply, venous drainage. So I will go to the whiteboard now, because we already see, no, where which artery, nerve and vein is there. So now we will go to the arterial supply. So as you already know, the arterial supply from the external carotid artery, it is giving what? Lingual artery. This lingual artery is giving two branches, deep lingual artery and sublingual artery. This is the arterial supply. One more thing, root of the tongue. Suppose ye tumhara tongue hai, to ye aisa genioglossus aur aisa sab, this is the root of the tongue. As you know, the tongue is divided into anterior two third, posterior one third and the posterior most part of the tongue. Right? Yes, this is the foramen cecum, from where thyroglossal duct develops, thyroid gland develops. So this is the anterior two-third. Now if you see this, this posteriormost part of the tongue, it is supplied by tonsillar artery. Ye tonsils, you will learn about Waldeyer's rings of tonsils. Waldeyer's ring of tonsils. We have discussed this sometime back also once. Tonsillar artery, you will discuss about the tonsils, that is the lymph nodes in the Waldeyer's ring. Okay, so the artery supplying to the tonsils is tonsillar artery. It also supplies the posterior part of the tongue. This is the point you have to mention. And other branch is ascending pharyngeal branch of external carotid. Ascending pharyngeal branch of external carotid. So when you will read about external carotid artery, when we will discuss in detail, I will tell you about these branches. Okay, so arterial supply ho gaya. Now venous drainage, you already saw that jo artery wo vein hai, veins up there going and draining into what? See, sublingual artery was there, sublingual vein was there. Deeplingual artery was there, deeplingual vein was there. They were going and draining into what? Do you recall they were going and draining into what? Come on, anyone, can you tell me, can you recall the diagram? They are going into the lingual vein, right? They are going into the lingual vein. And this is going into internal jugular vein. Simple, right? There is a common trunk which is draining the lingual vein, which is draining the retromandibular vein. We already discussed when we talked about the venous drainage of face in detail. It is also draining the facial vein. Facial vein, deep facial vein, we already seen. So, and the common facial vein, all this. So, all these come and drain here in this common drainage which goes to internal jugular vein. So, this is the venous drainage. Now, coming to the nerve supply. Nerve supply can be, see, because it's a muscular part and because it's a sensory part, which gives sensations. So, you can have two possibilities. One is sensory, second is motor. About motor, I've already told you, all muscles, movements of all, extrinsic, intrinsic, all included, they are supplied by cranial nerve number 12, that is hyoglossus. Okay, and that is the cranioglossus, right? Hyoglossus, I'm sorry. Hypoglossal nerve, I'm extremely sorry, I'm making spelling mistakes. Hypoglossal nerve, that is, except one muscle, that is, except palatoglossus. So, palatoglossus is supplied by, as I told you, pharyngeal plexus and cranial nerve number 11. Understood? Cranial nerve number 11. Pharyngeal plexus and cranial nerve number 11. This is the palatoglossus. Okay? All muscles are supplied by cranial nerve number 12, that is hypoglossal nerve. Coming to the sensory part, if you see, sensory part you have general sensory, special sensory. Now in this also, just one second, you have the anterior two-third, posterior one-third, and I will write here in black color. See, just one second. So this we are discussing about the sensory. So this is anterior two-third, this is posterior one-third, and this is posterior most. So as you know, general sensory is supplied by, as I told you just now, that is the lingual nerve, right? Which is a branch of mandibular nerve, that is third trigeminal nerve ka branch hai. Mandibular nerve is CN53, cranial nerve, third branch of fifth nerve, fifth cranial nerve. So is it lingual? Am I right? Yes, it's a lingual nerve. Okay, it is taking care of the general sensation. General sensation means what? Touch, pressure, okay, all this. And special means what? The taste. Can our skin taste something what we have put? No. But it can feel. Maine hum mere haath ke upar haath rakha, mere ungli rakha. So my hand can feel that something is touching. If I apply pressure, my hand can understand that it is some pressure is applied, right? But if I keep food here, it is not able to taste it. Why? Because it doesn't have special sense. It just has general sensations. This is about what? This is about the rest of the skin. But if I talk about tongue, if I keep my finger on the tongue, do everything practical. Don't leave anything. Do everything practical. So if I keep my finger on the tongue, my tongue will understand that there is some touch over the tongue. If I apply pressure, my tongue will understand that there is pressure. This is all done by whom? General sensation. Carried by whom? Lingual nerve, which is a branch of mandibular nerve, which is a branch of or a division of the cranial nerve number 5, that is the trigeminal nerve. But if I keep something on my tongue with respect to some taste, it will identify because it has special senses. Special sense kiske hai? Which nerve? Can anyone tell me? Yes, caudate tympani, which is a branch of 7th facial nerve, 7th cranial nerve, that is the facial nerve. Caudate tympani, we saw the structure, we saw the concept of pre-traumatic nerves, right? I told you, yes, yeah, the cranial nerve hai, aur isko first pharyngeal arch ko, either second pharyngeal arch ko, this is first pharyngeal arch, this is second pharyngeal arch. Branch from this comes and supplies. This is the pre-traumatic nerve. So this is the caudate tympani. First is mandibular nerve, right? Mandibular nerve, first arch nerve. Second is facial nerve. Third is glossopharyngeal nerve, right? Glossopharyngeal nerve. Do you recall it? So So there is no facial nerve supply to the tongue except for caudate tympani. Why? Because second pharyngeal arch does not mainly contribute to the formation of the tongue, because it regresses in the form of foramen cecum. Posterior one third of the tongue is formed by whom? It is formed by the third arch. The third arch, right? And third arch is supplied by glossopharyngeal. Glossopharyngeal has both special sensations as well as general sensations. So general sensations and special sensations both in the posterior one third are supplied by cranial nerve number 9. And posterior most carried out by vagus. That is the 10th cranial nerve. Actually, it is the branch, superior pharyngeal branch of the external pharyngeal branch of the vagus nerve. It is, if you recall, can you recall that? To be very specific, I will tell you the name. Just give me one moment. I have that name with me. It is the pharyngeal branch of the superior laryngeal branch of the vagus nerve. I will write it because it is confusing me. But I hope you understand. General sensation and special sensation, anterior two-third, posterior one-third, and the posterior most, this is there. I will write this posterior most, that is the 10th cranial nerve supply to the tongue. It is which branch? You remember this name because it is asked in MCQs and Viva question. If you answer this, if you mention the name so specifically, examiner will be definitely, he will be giving you good marks. It is the pharyngeal branch of superior laryngeal nerve, which is a branch of cranial nerve number 10, that is vagus. Pharyngeal branch of superior laryngeal nerve of the cranial nerve number 10, that is the vagus. So this was the nerve supply. Now lymphatic drainage, I will just enumerate, not so much significant. I mean, if carcinomas and all, it's significant. See, now take the tongue. This tip of the tongue, this tip goes and supplies in what? Submental. Mandible to the niche, submental. The foramen is there. So submental lymph nodes. Okay, you have already learned about the submental lymph nodes when we talked about the space. Do you recall which space? Spaces of the neck. Yeah, spaces of the neck. Posterior triangle. When we were talking about the fascia, investing layer of the fascia. Deep cervical fascia. Then this anterior two-third, as I already told you, tongue is divided like this. This anterior two-third. This goes and supplies in what? It goes and supplies in the submandibular. Submandibular group of lymph nodes. Okay. Kidhar hai, kya hai? You will see if you go through the lymphatic drainage of the neck, you will get an overview. Okay, and these further go and drain into the deep cervical lymph nodes. Deep cervical lymph nodes. And this whole complete goes to jugulo-omohyoid nodes, which are also called as, I'm not writing John, okay, jugulo-omohyoid lymph nodes. They are called as lymph node of tongue. Okay, lymph node of tongue. Lymph node of tongue. So, this is an MCQ question. It's given in the textbook. You can go through. So, and posterior most, it is drained by the upper deep cervical lymph nodes, this posterior wale, but ye directly isme drain karte hai, ye submandibular wale jaake deep, I will draw it in a flow chart, wait, so that it becomes very easy for you to understand, just give me one moment. So this anterior most is submental, iska to alag hi hai, okay, and this is going in submandibular lymph nodes. The submandibular lymph nodes go in deep cervical lymph nodes. These directly drain into deep cervical lymph nodes. And these all go into whom? They go in. Can anyone tell me? Yes, I told just now. Jugulo-omohyoid lymph nodes. These are also called as lymph nodes of, just one second, of tongue. Simple to understand? Okay. This is about lymphatic drainage. Now coming to the applied anatomy. My favorite, your favorite. अच्छा इट्स अ सॉफ्ट टिश्यू मस्कुलर ऑर्गन है तो उसका क्या रहेगा कार्सिनोमा रहेगा तो तंबाकू खाने वालों को माउथ कैंसर होता है तो दे गेट व्हाइट प्लाक्स विच स्टार्ट ब्लीडिंग आई मीन प्लाक्स PLAQUES चट्टे पांडरे चट्टे इन मराठी दे कॉल इट एज व्हाइट प्लाक्स PLAQUES ओके व्हाइट प्लाक्स पांडरे चट्टे So carcinogenic, you go and see the genetic mechanism, you will learn it in pathology. What are the factors causing cancer and all this and that. Big answers you have to write. It's a big new plus. It's a big chapter in pathology. It's a big chapter. White plaque, then they become reddish and then they bleed and this and they get carcinogenic. And they start growing. So block dissection is done because block dissection, you will understand what it is as a method of removing the lymph nodes in surgery. The different levels of lymph nodes in the neck, accordingly block dissection is done. And there are different, the methods for this in surgery. Okay, different methods. So they remove the lymph nodes also because this carcinoma can be drained into the lymphatic system and it can go to the lymph nodes and then go in the total lymphatic system and spread by the lymphatic means and it's dangerous. Okay. The second thing is if you give Now, if you see, there are some drugs which are given sublingually. Sublingually म्हणजे जिभेच्या खाली ठेवलं की ते वितळतात. अँड वन ऑफ द लाईफ सेव्हिंग ड्रग्स इज ट्राय नायट्राइट ग्लिसरीन ग्लिसरीन ट्राय नायट्राइट ऑर नायट्रोग्लिसरीन. इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज नायट्रोग्लिसरीन. दिस इज गिवन टू रिलीव अंजायना. अंजायना ओके व्हेरी इंपॉर्टंट ड्रग. और ऑल्सो सॉर्बिट्रेट इज ऑल्सो द ड्रग. उसी का नाम है. ये ट्राय नायट्रेट है, ये सॉर्बिट्रेट. ये तो क्लासिफिकेशन इन फार्मा यू विल लर्न. इट रिलीव अंजायना. सो दिस इज गिवन सबलिंगुअली ओके फॉर इमीडिएट रिलीफ बिकॉज दैट रीजन बिलो द tongue is richly supplied by blood. Just now you saw your tongue or either niche se artery are sare lingual sublingual or deep lingual vagera vagera. So that is a blood rich supply, vascular rich supply, and so the blood gets absorbed there very quickly and it has immediate action. Okay, one more thing. Now genioglossus muscle you saw, right? Genioglossus muscle kya karta hai? This is your mandible, this is your tongue, this is your tongue, right? This is your tongue. So genioglossus muscle is like this. What genioglossus muscle does, it pulls out your tongue, right? It will contract like this, it will pull out your tongue. So it is causing protrusion. So when the person is unconscious, someone was arguing with me 2 days back about consciousness, no problem. When a person is unconscious, at that time, this tongue can fall behind and it can block the airway and person can die because of lack of breathing, because of asphyxia. Okay, so this genioglossus muscle is the muscle which is called as the safety muscle. It is called as the safety muscle. Safety muscle. Okay, it is called as the safety muscle. Why genioglossus? Because it does not allow the tongue to fall back. It does not allow the tongue to fall back. When you are unconscious, it falls. Or when you are given a general anesthesia, that is GA, so tongue will fall behind. So what they catch hold of the tongue. So when you are conscious, the genioglossus muscle is called as the safety muscle because it does not allow your tongue to fall back. So it is called as the safety muscle. Because if it is paralyzed, the tongue will fall back in the oropharynx and block the air passage. And especially during anesthesia, the tongue is pulled forwards to clear this air passage because this muscle is paralyzed at that time and nothing can be done. So person will die out of asphyxia because of the tongue fall because of anesthesia. And it is the only muscle which protrudes the tongue outside, forwards. Okay, so to test the integrity of the hypoglossal nerve, you can simply check this. Actually, in physiology, you will learn how to test the 12 cranial nerves. First cranial nerve, second cranial nerve, third cranial nerve. How to test each and every nerve when you are seeing a patient of nervous system. Okay, you have respiratory system, right? You check na, one by one, CBS, RS. So like that, when you are checking the nervous system, so there are different tests. You check cranial nerves. And for cranial nerves, for the 12th cranial nerve, that is the hypoglossal nerve, to check the integrity, you can ask the person to put his tongue outside, protrude his tongue outside. Tell the person, and like this. So, now as you know that there are two hypoglossal nerves, right? There are 12 pairs of cranial nerves. So, if the hypoglossal nerve of the right side is paralyzed, the tongue will fall on the, it will, protrusion will deviate to the right side. Because normal left side is there, no? So, it will pull. Are you understanding what I'm saying? I will tell you. See. See, this is your tongue. Okay. This is the anterior. This is the posterior. Ye idhar ka hypoglossal nerve, idhar ka hypoglossal nerve. And genioglossus is like this, right? It is coming like this. This is the direction of the muscle fiber, right? Ye tubercle aage rahega na, mandible ka. Tumhare muh ke andar dekh rahe ho, andar se. So, the direction of contraction will be like this, right? Like this. So, if this sided nerve is paralyzed, if this nerve is damaged, so this half of the genioglossus, that is this muscle, will get paralyzed. But this will have normal action. What it will do? It will contract. It will contract. So, tongue will deviate on the side which is correct. It will not deviate on the side which is faulty. म्हणजे या साइडची लिंगुअल नर्व जर का तुमची डॅमेज असेल तर ज्या साइडची डॅमेज आहे त्याच्या विरुद्ध दिशेला टंग ही फॉल होणार. अंडरस्टूड? आर यू अंडरस्टँडिंग? बिकॉज द अदर साइड इज करेक्ट, सो कॉन्ट्रॅक्शन विल हॅपन अँड सो इट विल डेविएट टू दॅट साइड. दिस बोथ इंटेग्रिटी ऑफ बोथ दिस नर्व्स. What is happening? Your trunk is protruding in the forward direction. Not in the left, not in the right. Understood? In the forward direction. But if one side is paralyzed, suppose right is paralyzed, then what will happen? This side action will not happen. Tongue will not go outside like this, from this side. Okay? And it will fall on this side. Because this is normal. If both are normal, tongue will not fall outside. It will not protrude. And it will fall inside and it will block the airway. Understood? So I hope you have understood. I have attempted to summarize the whole thing of the tongue. Thank you very much. If you have any doubts, you can ask me.
Thank you.
this is an interesting fact. I mean, it's very much interesting to understand. I personally felt it, so I'm sharing with you. See, when you dissect the neck, the region below the mandible, this is mandible. See, what is this view? Antero-inferior view. मतलब सामने से देख रहे हो और इंफीरियर व्यू है, मतलब तुमने पर्सन यू हैव आस्क्ड द पर्सन टू स्लीप लाइक दिस एंड ये इसका गर्दन तुमने ऐसा पीछे किया, तो तुमको नेक पूरा अच्छे से दिखेगा, समझ में आया क्या? सो दिस इज दैट व्यू और तुम सामने से देख रहे हो, एंटेरो इंफीरियर व्यू. नाउ दिस इज द माइलॉइड मसल, कैन यू सी माइलॉइड, सॉरी माइलॉइड मसल, कैन यू सी दिस माइलॉइड मसल? इफ यू रिकॉल द सेवन डायफ्राम्स ऑफ योर बॉडी, दैट चैप्टर फ्रॉम विच वी हैड स्टार्टेड अवर वेबिनार्स, आई हैड डिस्कस्ड द सेवन डायफ्राम्स इन योर बॉडी. One of the diaphragm, that is the oral diaphragm, is mylohyoid muscle. Do you recall? Yeh dekho, yeh, this is the mylohyoid muscle. Understood? This is the mylohyoid muscle and it is the oral diaphragm. Now, if you remove this muscle, can you see the direction of the fibers is like this? Actually, it is like this. Sorry, I put it in the wrong direction. Mylohyoid. So, idhar myloid line rehta hai, mandible ke upar. Udhar se niche aa raha hai, hyoid ki taraf. So, what is the action, what is the nerve supply, I'm not going in details of that. I just want to get you to understand this, that it is one of the diaphragms. Don't think that are hawa mein baatein kar raha tha diaphragm. I will explain in the optic diaphragm also when we will talk about the eye. We have already seen the urogenital diaphragm when we talk. We have already seen those diaphragms which are below your navel when we discuss the abdomen. Now we discussed respiratory diaphragm, and now we are talking about the oral diaphragm, that is the mylohyoid diaphragm, mylohyoid muscle, which forms the oral diaphragm. Now when you dissect this muscle, so I will draw the flowchart here only. Okay, ये मसल को जब तुम ओपन करते हो ना, ऐसा डिसेक्ट आउट करते हो बाहर, तो इसके नीचे तुमको क्या दिखता है पता है? आई विल जस्ट राइट द फ्लो चार्ट. दिस आउटसाइड इन माइलोहायोइड मसल, देन माइलोहायोइड को ओपन करने के बाद तुमको क्या दिखेगा? तुम थोड़ा ये एरो बड़ा हो गया, एक सेकेंड. हाँ, माइलोहायोइड के बाद तुमको दिखेगा हायोग्लॉसस मसल. अब ये डायग्राम में नहीं दिख रहा है, दूसरे डायग्राम में है, लेकिन मैं आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू कंफ्यूज यू. हायोग्लॉसस मसल, और हायोग्लॉसस मसल को तुम अगर ओपन, आई मीन व्हेन यू dissect it out, you are going to go to geniohyoid muscle. Geniohyoid muscle. And geniohyoid muscle. Geniohyoid को dissect out कर दे, उसका deep कौन है? उसके deep genioglossus muscle. जो अभी हमने discuss किया ना tongue के बारे में, genioglossus muscle. तो outside in, this is the sequence. Or you can say, superficial to deep, this is the sequence. This is for your understanding. No one will ask you in the viva anywhere in the exam, but it is very much interesting to understand how is the sequence, how is the orientation, how are those muscles placed.